gon' talk about me, they gon' talk about me. They can't walk around me, they can't walk around me. Bitch, I'm rich as fuck, bitch, I'm rich as fuck. The most can sick a dog, you can sick a dog. I get 10 Brazilians like I'm Dan Brazerin. I get 10 Brazilians like I'm Dan Brazerin. Bitch, I'm rich as fuck, bitch, I'm rich as fuck. The most can sick a dog, bitch, you sick a dog.
What is going on, guys?
They gon' talk about me, they gon' talk about me.
Should we run it back again?
They can't walk around me, they can't walk around me. Bitch, I'm...
What is going on, guys? Brad Messersmith here from the Fantasy Golf Degenerates, bringing you another expert model breakdown on the fantasyfanatics.com. Make sure to get over there and become a premium member, as always, to get all of the action you're going to see here. You can download my personal expert model and play with the picks that I am playing with, and see all the golfers that my statistical model likes. So without hesitation, let's go ahead and get right into it. We are on to the Shell Houston Open, which is a little stronger field than the Puerto Rico Open of last week. By now you probably know that DA Points won, but it's still not exactly the strongest field you would care for. Little bit weaker than you can expect for next week at the Masters, kind of average field. So, all of that being said, let's go through the stats first. Strokes gained tee to green is correlated in a massive way in the trends tool, more so than it typically is. This week, I am going to give it a 5 weighting in the model. Definitely a stat that I want to target heavily. Strokes gained approach in a similar front correlates really, really well. We'll talk about a couple of guys who are really good in this category, but that category alone is going to help drive a lot of my decisions as well this week. Birdie or better percentage should be no surprise at this point. It gets a 3 weighting this week. Total driving is a little bit of a different stat, not one that you typically see in my models, but does correlate well, shows up in some of the other statistical analysis that I'm doing outside of the Fantasy Fanatics. So definitely a stat I wanted to get in here. DraftKings points gained par 72 is a stat that you will see on most par 72 courses. You'll see it correlate pretty well in the trends tool, so went ahead and put that in there. And then last but not least, a little bit of a unique outlier here, proximity from the rough shows up in the trends tool and also shows up in some of my own statistical analysis. In fact, birdie or better percentage from the rough is one of the highest correlations I have in my own stats model outside of the fantasyfanatics.com. So proximity from the rough I put in here with the lower weight. Probably not going to be the stat I use to drive decisions, but a good, very interesting differentiator when you're trying to decide between different golfers. So let's go ahead and get right into it. I'm actually not going to cover too many golfers in the higher salary ranges this week. Honestly, I took a look, thought about adding a couple guys in here, but it's hard to go wrong actually this week. A lot of golfers with very good prices, very good recent form, some pretty solid course history candidates as well above 9K. So I'm gonna let you guys make those decisions. If you want to get more information on who I like, make sure to get over to the Fantasy Golf Degenerates podcast, and we'll go through the entire slate there. Follow me on Twitter at BMSDFS to get some more info. First guy I like is a guy who typically is pretty well underpriced, but is not this week, and that's JB Holmes. Still not so sure about his ownership percentage, but is 7th overall in my model. Statistically seems to fit the course very well. Recent form is good, and course history is very, very good. So JB Holmes is a guy who you've heard me talk about for many, many weeks in a row. This week's no different. I'm hoping that his increased price will kind of make people want to go elsewhere with their picks. I'm not really sure how much ownership these guys are going to get up in this range. So I think a lot of these guys, actually 9K and above, are going to change throughout the week quite a bit. So make sure to update your models and make sure to follow me on Twitter so you can find out when I'm updating the ownership projections. But I have a feeling there's going to be some big fluctuations this week because typically recent form and course history both reign king. In this case, we've got a lot of guys with really good of both. So going to be going to be really dependent on what the industry is saying this week in terms of the ownership projections. So after J.B. Holmes, Matt Kuchar, I have him marked in yellow because I'm a little bit hesitant here. I think his ownership is going to be one that trends upward because of his very elite course history. Several top 10s here at this course. I think last year he did not necessarily perform very well, but has quite a few data points there. Statistically, he's one that does not fit my model as well. So there's a little bit there, I think, that speaks to him being a fade, especially with what I expect to be upward trending ownership for Matt Kuchar. Cabrera Bayo is a guy who is probably one of my favorite guys on the slate. There are definitely some guys I like better, but he is a guy that I think, in terms of just stats and skill alone, is underpriced. Some of the statistical analysis I'm doing outside of the Fantasy Fanatics really points in a huge way to RCB, in a way that it doesn't typically point to guys. So RCB is a guy I wanted to mention. I think he's going to make his way into a lot of my lineups. Peter Uihlein, I talked about him, I believe it was a couple weeks ago. Was it at the Puerto Rico? Yeah, it was last week. Definitely a guy I really liked. A player who is a little bit under the radar, but very, very skilled golfer. Trained with Brooks Koepka and Jordan Spieth overseas in Europe. Unlike those two guys, he chose to stay over in Europe and continue to compete there. So it doesn't have a whole lot of PGA Tour data points, but is a very, very skilled and talented golfer. Has won this year on the Euro Tour. I believe he finished around fifth place last week. So a guy that I'm going to jump back on this week. Tony Finau, if you follow me at all on social media, if you listen to me on the podcast, you know Tony Finau is my favorite play of the slate this week. At 7,100, I think he's safe for cash. I think he has tons of upside. In fact, look out for me making a bet on the podcast with Kenny. We haven't recorded yet, but I plan on challenging him to an avatar bet of some sort. So we'll see where that goes. But I think I'm going to take Tony Finau over almost the entire field this week. There's very few guys who I like better than Tony Finau. And when you factor in his 7,100 price, he's golden for me. I very rarely take 100% of guys in GPPs. This might be a week that I would consider going very heavy on Tony Finau. Jason Duffner is a guy who I think is also a very, very good value. He's a grinder, statistically really fits this course well. I don't remember his course history off the top of my head. Looks like he doesn't have much. So 77th place finish in 2009. But with his statistical fit in my model and the way he's been playing recently, I really like Jason Duffner. There's a lot of things that point to him. The stars are sort of aligning a bit with Jason Duffner. So definitely a guy I'm going to be playing quite a bit of in GPPs. You guys aren't going to believe this. I think I might have to roster a little bit of Keegan Burn Your House Down Bradley. Let's just hope he doesn't turn into a dumpster fire before the end of the weekend, which is always a risk with Keegan. But statistically, he fits okay. He's way underpriced at 7,100, and he's never popular. I don't expect that to change this week, at least not in any major way. Having something like 10 to 15% of Keegan most likely will be overweight on the field. So you don't have to take a whole lot of risk of making your way to a dumpster on the weekend. And so as much as I hate to say it, I think I'll have a little bit of Keegan this week. I did flag Bernd Wiesberger because I want to talk about how his ranking looks in my model. Right now, he is ranked number one overall. Now, don't get ahead of yourself. The reason he is ranked number one overall is because he has some missing stats. So if you look in here, his average rank in all of the stats that he does have is 8.8, which is part of why his stats look very, very high. Part of the reason for this is because I'm using 2016-2017 stats. I always recommend when you're making your own models, when you're using my model, go back, recalculate using 2015-2016 stats, and just see what the difference is. You might find that guys like Bernd Wiesberger, when they have all of their stats incorporated, are not going to show up as highly rated as you might think. So something to keep in mind. I did want to point that out. with Burnt. I don't dislike him this week, but he is definitely not my number one favorite guy in terms of my model or in terms of just who I'm going to be playing this week. Beef Johnson had a really nice week last week, finished 10th place at the Puerto Rico Open. I don't like to overreact to these things, and I think in general the public probably will. But he does have a pretty nice statistical fit for what his price is. He's almost a minimum price, and he there's some things that, you know, things like rough proximity, things like strokes gained, tee to green don't really speak the same language with Beef. But between total driving and rough proximity, it boosts his stats just enough for me to really think that he's somebody I'm going to get on, especially coming into form like he is. Kyle Reifers is another guy who I think is probably one of my favorite plays of the week. At 6,400, he's an extremely skilled golfer. Hasn't really had his coming out party to this point, I don't think. But he is very, very good, very talented golfer. Statistically, there's some concerns there for sure. You're going to get that with any golfer that's 6,400. But recent form, he finished 17th place last week, is definitely very volatile, but is seeming to round into form a little bit. And the course history is pretty darn phenomenal. 7th, 11th, and 21st place finishes in his three tries here. So he is a golfer that I am definitely going to be on in GPPs. I may even consider Kyle Reifers if I have to get that low in cash. I'm not sure I will this week with some of these other salaries that are here, but definitely don't dislike Kyle Reifers in GPPs. So that's going to wrap it up. That's going to cover everything that I wanted to cover. As I said before, make sure to become a premium member on thefantasyfanatics.com to get access to all of these tools. You can download my very own GPP model that I'll be using to generate my lineups. You can use the lineup generator, course trends, all kinds of really good stuff. Get over there. Use the link in the description to get there, and you can get access to all of this good stuff. If you like these videos every week and you want me to have them continue, make sure to subscribe so you can get them every single week. Don't miss a single one. Lots of good value here. Make sure to hit that subscribe button. Leave a comment. Leave a like. Really helps me out. And as before, follow me on Twitter @BMSDFS. We will catch you guys next time.